Welcome, folks, to another Yards of the Catch podcast. Today, I will be previewing the 2010 Philadelphia Eagles. This is a team that went 11-5 last year, but struggled in two embarrassing losses to the Dallas Cowboys. The biggest question mark for this team, the biggest storyline for this team, is the institution of Kevin Cobb as their franchise long-term quarterback in replacement of Donovan McNabb. And I will look to their offense first. And I will look at their passing game first as well. And I think this is a passing game that's evolved over the last couple of years with the additions and the breakouts of two home run hitting receivers and a nice productive tight end. Kevin Cobb won't be short of options in a passing game with DeSean Jackson, diminutive but extremely quick, extremely fast, game breaking speed, 4.3, 4.2 speed, and it can score from anywhere on the field from a variety of different ways, even on special teams. But also, second year Jeremy Maclin, who I think is similar in his ability after the catch, his speed, and his quickness, but is a little bit bigger of an option, and I think is more of a Reggie Wayne type of physique and type of impact in this offense. We also saw Brent Celek break out. He led the team in catches, and I thought he might have gotten snubbed for the NFC Pro Bowl, but this is a guy that is very nice in the passing game, not the most athletic guy, but a big presence and very tough to tackle after the catch, but he's not a very good run blocker, and I think that's a theme that we'll see among their tight ends. Cornelius Ingram is a second year player, didn't get a chance to play last year due to an ACL tear, and also Clay Harbor, a rookie, H-back type prospect. And very athletic as well, and another option in the passing game, depending on how fast it will take for him to progress in the offense. But also, unheralded guys like Jason Avant coming out of the slot, a guy that can run a variety of short routes and get open, especially in critical situations, third downs and whatnot. And I really like the rookie Riley Cooper, big, physical, definitely that type of scrappy personality, but has enough speed to even stretch the field and get separation on a variety of routes. So I think they have a balanced group of receivers, a balanced group of wideouts, we'll see how Kevin Cobb manages this. We saw Donovan McNabb be a little bit inconsistent as far as his accuracy in the short and intermediate areas, but we also saw Donovan McNabb excel with passes down the field, and Kevin Cobb certainly doesn't have that type of an arm and that type of field stretching capability, but he definitely has very good accuracy. I think it's an upgrade as far as accuracy and consistency in that area. And I like Kevin Cobb's sense of timing. And I think he'll aid the pass protection in that. He'll get the ball out of his hands and complete high percentage plays. So we might see a little more consistency in the passing game going forward. But with the running game, this is a team that offensively I've criticized for years, and that in their lack of balance, especially in critical situations and critical games late in the season. I thought in the last couple of games against the Cowboys, this offense largely fizzled because of their lack of balance and their lack of running game. You know, they do have a big offensive line, a huge offensive line, one of the biggest in the league. But they haven't had injury issues up front, and also their specialty is actually pass protection. So I think their running game would really improve, especially their offensive line, and with the return of Jamal Jackson from his injury, I thought that hurt them late in the season at center. And with Todd Harriman's, he needs to be healthy at left guard. I think he's a decent run blocker. But overall, this is a good offensive line. Jason Peters at left tackle, I like his athleticism and his size. I think he's decent there. I thought that was a great pickup for them. And he was solid in pass protection last year. And also Winston Justice. We saw him got abused before in the past by elite defensive ends. But I think he's settled in and has a home at right tackle. I think he has good athleticism. I'd like to see, again, him improve in the run game. But he's a good pass protector. So I like the bookends, especially in pass protection. At guard, we should see Stacey Andrews potentially step up and keep that job at right guard. He's been banged up in the past, and he's versatile as well. He can play right guard, right tackle. So we'd like to see him solidify that job. And at left guard, Todd Harriman, like I said, needs to return from injury. Right now, Max Jean Gillis is in practicing instead. And I do like him as a backup, but as a starter, I think he will be a bit subpar. And Nick Cole right now is subbing in for Jamal Jackson at center. Again, I think as a starter, is a decent substitution for Jamal Jackson due to his injury. But overall, I think Jamal Jackson is one of the better centers in the game, and I think he would be huge as far as improving the run blocking, especially in the interior offensive line. But as far as the backfield, I think they've improved the backfield. Certainly, they've tried to move on from Brian Westbrook era by drafting LeSean McCoy last year. Certainly, Westbrook is off the roster now. And it's LeSean McCoy. They brought in Mike Bell as a bigger, maybe change of pace, maybe a goal line presence to back him up. And they also drafted Charles Scott and Leonard Weaver, Pro Bowl fullback, is still on the roster. So they have a group of guys that can carry the rock, a group of guys that can bring different things to the table. Charles Scott is a nimble power back. Leonard Weaver is a versatile fullback type. And Mike Bell is a physical guy, and he hasn't stayed healthy all the time, but he's a physical guy. He could do some things between the tackles. But I think LeSean McCoy needs to step up and improve his decisiveness in the interior. He's very quick, exceptional change of direction, exceptional burst. And I think he will continue to clean up his game. But overall, this offense, like I said, I would like to see more balance, and I'd like to see some more consistency in their passing game. But overall, I think with the institution of Kevin Cobb, with the improvements in the backfield, and with the possible improvements as far as health on the offensive line, and definitely the addition of a couple guys at receiver and tight end, I think this offense has a ton of upside, and I think it could be one of the best in the top 10, maybe even top 5 offenses if it's on its game. Defensively, for the Eagles, very good amount of talent on all 3 levels. But consistency, again, was the issue with this team late in the season. We saw their coverage break down a little bit. We saw their pass rush break down a little bit. But, again, this is a team that was one of the league leaders in both interceptions and sacks. So this is a team that can make plays and can get to the quarterback, but it needs to be more consistent, and they've certainly tried to address that. On the defensive line, they've swapped in Daryl Tapp for Chris Clemens in a trade. I think Tapp is versatile, and I think he can do some different things in different packages. What I really am looking forward to seeing is Brandon Graham, because we know Trent Cole is an elite defensive end. He truly is great versus the run and the pass, and very underrated as a pass rusher. And he got 12.5 sacks last year. Juku Parker is a nice pass rusher on the strong side, but I think Brandon Graham is an upgrade. And I think he was the best pass rusher in this draft, and that's saying a lot because this is a deep draft. And I think Graham will take one of those starting jobs down the road, and I think Cole and Graham could be a tremendous duo as pass rushers. But they've also added Daniel Tail Nesheim, another rookie, and I think overall this is a deep, talented crop of defensive ends. A defensive tackle, they've done a pretty good job versus the run. I really like Bunkley and Patterson duo. They've had that for a while. Strong guys, not tremendous pass rushers at all, but very good versus the run. What they want from their defensive tackles. Trevor Laws, I think he might be coming on a third-year player as a potential guy that could come in sub-packages. And Jeff Owens is a big physical guy, rookie at defensive tackle. The linebackers, they return Stuart Bradley. I think he's not the fastest guy, not the best in coverage, but I think he'll be a decent run defender and a leader for that linebacking group. And there'll be a good competition, a strong side between Moise Foku and Akeem Jordan. They brought in Ernie Sims at weak side, very fast, very explosive, but a lot to prove because I think he's had a couple subpar years. And in the secondary, Asante Samuels has some decent years, especially because he makes a lot of plays, a very instinctive guy. But I think between Asante Samuel, Ellis Hobbs, and Josiah Hansen, Macho Harris, and Trevor Ard-Lindley, the rookie, I think they have a bunch of guys with some skill to play some man coverage, but a lot to prove and a lot of inconsistency. And we'll see how they do with the revamped pass rush. And at safety, the starter rookie at free safety, Nate Allen, I think he has range, size, ball skills, and I think he'll be decent in the long run. And I think he has a great guy standing next to him with Quentin Michael, a strong safety. I think with the load let up on him a little bit, less man coverage exposure, I think Quentin Michael can be a Brian Dawkins type of not quite on that level, but that type of impact in the secondary if allowed to roam, allowed to do his thing. But overall, the defense needs to improve their consistency in all 3 phases. But overall, I think they've upgraded, and I think we'll see a good defense, and I think we'll see a good team overall. I think this team that's going to compete for the Super Bowl. I think they're under the radar, and as they walk out.
See and peek how you peek and see what you get. Know what I'm talking about? We see.